When it comes to painting the interior of your house or unit, it is important that you have the right tools and prepare the surface correctly before you paint. I'm going to show you everything you will need to know to get your next DIY interior painting project prepped and ready for painting. Compared to many of the other trades, a painter's tools are relatively easy to acquire and not overly expensive. The tools you need to prepare for the most common interior surfaces are sugar soap, painter's tape, plastic and cloth drop sheets, a dust mask, sandpaper, interior filler, a filling blade, gap filler, and a corking gun. Step 1. Clear and cover. Once you have all your tools, it is important to clear out your space that you are going to paint. Remove any breakables from tables and shelves and take down any pictures and artwork from the walls. For large items like a bed or sofa, you can simply move these items into the center of the room and cover it with a plastic drop sheet. Step 2. Wash. Check to see if the walls are clean of dirt and grime. If not, you will need to clean with sugar soap and use a clean cloth or sponge to give them a quick wipe down. A great new product on the market are these sugar soap wipes. If you are just painting one wall, this is the best way to go as it will replace the need for a bucket, sponge, and sugar soap. Step 3. Fill imperfections. Fill any holes with filler. It is important that you use the correct filler. One common DIY mistake is filling holes with gap filler. Gap filler is rubbery and difficult to sand, so will show up as an imperfection later on. So use the correct filler for the job you are doing. Once the filler is dry, you will need to sand and seal with a product like 3-in-1 or PSU. Step 4. Sand and dust. Sand the walls using a pole sander. Use a 180 to 120 grit or fine sandpaper. Attach the sandpaper to the sanding pole head and move it up and down and from one side to the other so that you systematically cover the whole surface. Then dust down with a broom or rag. Step 5. Gap cracks. Next, you will need to fill any gaps between your walls, skirting boards, and architraves with gap filler. Fill by leading with the gap nozzle. That way, you push the gap filler into the crack. Then use your finger or a damp rag to create a smooth finish. Step 6. Tape. Once the walls are clean or dusted down, you will then need to apply painter's tape to your architraves and skirting. To avoid bleeding, make sure you keep the tape as close to the corners as you can and pat it down well to avoid bubbles and wrinkles. Here are a couple of tips. Many of these tools can be purchased from your local hardware. However, we recommend you purchase them from your local paint retail or trade centre. There you will find a greater wealth of painting knowledge and experience. There will also be someone there to serve you every time. To protect the floors, always use drop sheets. You have the choice of plastic or cloth. Plastic drop sheets are cheap and effective, but they can be slippery. They also do not soak up the paint, spilt, and may just transfer it from your shoe so that it can be walked into another room. I would recommend using plastic drop sheets and then place a cotton one over the top. That way you have the best of both worlds. You would think that there would just be one option for tape, but there are several. You can choose different tack levels or levels of stickiness to suit the duration of your job. Make sure you use a very low tack tape when taping over recently painted surfaces. This tape has the added feature of edge lock, so that the paint won't bleed underneath. When choosing sandpaper, know that the lower the grit number, the more coarse the sandpaper is. So now you've got your tools, your steps, and a couple of tips. Go out and enjoy your first interior painting project.